हेलो एंड वेलकम टू क्लिपबोर्ड एजुकेशन। टुडे वी विल स्टडी चैप्टर 9 ऑफ क्लास 8th एनसीईआरटी साइंस। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट।
हेलो एंड वेलकम टू क्लिपबोर्ड एजुकेशन। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस चैप्टर 9 ऑफ क्लास 8th एनसीईआरटी साइंस। द नेम ऑफ चैप्टर इज रिप्रोडक्शन इन एनिमल्स। सो लेट्स मूव फॉरवर्ड। वी हैड स्टडीड इन प्रीवियस क्लासेस दैट plants reproduce in two ways. Like that, animals also produce in two ways. One is sexual reproduction and second is asexual reproduction. These are the two ways in which animals reproduce, the humans reproduce. What happens here? Like the reproductive parts of plants, animals also produce gametes that fuse to form a zygote. In the plants, there were stamens and pistils, but in the case of animals, there are sperms and eggs. These are called gametes that fuse to form a zygote. It is the zygote which develops into a new individual. The zygote develops into embryo, and then embryo turns to be a new individual. The type of reproduction beginning from the fusion of male and female gametes is called sexual reproduction. The sexual reproduction, there is a direct fusion of male and female gametes. Next we move, if we see at the male reproductive organs of a human, there are two testes. There are sperm ducts, there are urethra, and there is urinary bladder. So what happens here? Billions of sperms are produced by the testes. These sperms are very small in size. Each has a head, middle piece and a tail. And these sperms, when gets added to egg, then the fusion occurs and the fertilization process starts. If we see a picture of a sperm, a human sperm, it has a head, middle piece and a tail. And we must know that each sperm is a single cell with all the usual cell components. And now if we move towards female reproductive organs, the female reproductive organs are a pair of ovaries, oviducts and the uterus. So if we look at this picture, these are two ovaries, this is cervix, this is vagina and this is uterus. The ovary produces female gametes. What are the female gametes called? These are called eggs. In human beings, a single mature egg is released into the oviduct by one of the ovaries every month. So in the oviduct, what happens? These ovaries sends one egg, either of the ovary sends one egg every month to the oviduct. And the uterus is the part where development of the baby takes place. Like the sperm, egg is also a single cell. And we must know that when these eggs goes into oviducts and they fuse in the uterus, and the development of body of newborn is developed. So where the newborn, the tissues, the organs of the child starts developing. Like the sperm, egg is also a single cell. So we must know that as the sperm is a single cell, egg is also a single cell. The size of the eggs in small in animals varies. The egg may be very small as in humans, much larger as in hens. Ostrich egg is the largest. So the eggs of humans are very small, but the eggs of hens are much larger. ostrich egg is the largest. We must know that the egg of the ostrich is the largest thing. Now we move, what is fertilization? We must know that when sperms come in contact with an egg, one of the sperms may fuse with the egg. Such fusion of the egg with the sperm is called fertilization. And during fertilization, what happens? The nucleus of the sperm and the egg fuse to form a single nucleus. This results in the formation of a fertilized egg or zygote. As we already know that in fertilization, sperms and egg combine to form a zygote. So if we look closely, if we look deeper, we will know that the nucleus of the sperm during fertilization, the nucleus of the sperm and egg fuse to form a single nucleus. This results in the formation of fertilized egg or zygote. Now, the process of fertilization is the meeting of egg from the mother and a sperm cell from the father. What is fertilization? The meeting of sperm with egg. The new individual inherits some characters from the mother and some from father. As we already know, we have some characters from our mother and some from father. Fertilization, which takes place inside the female body, is called internal fertilization. So we must know that there are two kinds of fertilization. One is internal fertilization and another is external fertilization. The fertilization which occurs inside the body is called internal fertilization. What are the examples? Like the fertilization occurring in humans, cows, dogs and hens. Now what happens? We must know what are test tube babies. It's a very important thing. We must have some idea of this concept. What happens in some women? Oviducts get blocked. So women are unable to bear babies because sperms cannot reach the egg for fertilization. So in such cases, doctors collect freshly released egg and sperms, keep them together for a few hours for IVF or in vitro fertilization. Means he keeps the new eggs and sperms collected into an outer conditions. The fertilization outside the body, because the sperms and eggs are kept in outside condition outside the body. That's why we call it external fertilization. In cases fertilization occurs, the zygote is developed for about a week and then it is placed again in mother's uterus. So we give some 1 week or 2 week time for the zygote to start developing, and then again we place the zygote into the mother's womb, mother's uterus. Complete development takes place in the uterus and the baby is born like any other baby. Babies born through this technique are called test tube babies. We must know what are test tube babies. What happens in many animals? Fertilization takes place outside the body of the female. In these animals, fertilization takes place in water. What happens? There is another kind of fertilization, which is external fertilization. In this type of fertilization, the eggs and sperms meet outside the body. So what are the examples? The frogs. What happens during spring or rainy season? The frogs and toads move to ponds and slow flowing streams. When the male and female come together in water, the female lays hundreds of eggs. Unlike hen's egg, frog's egg is not covered by a shell. It's completely very delicate. A layer of jelly holds the eggs together and provides protection to the eggs. So in the rainy season, frogs, the female frog lays down eggs on ponds, slow flowing streams, and these eggs are jelly like. As the eggs are laid, the male deposits sperms over them. Each sperm swims randomly in water with the help of long tail. The sperms come in contact with the eggs. This results of fertilization. This type of fertilization, in which the fusion of a male and female gametes takes place outside the body of the female, is called sexual external fertilization. It is very common in aquatic animals such as fish, starfish, etc. So when the eggs are lying down on water, the male aquatic animal deposits sperms over them. So sperms swim randomly across the water, and when the sperms come in contact with the eggs, this results in the fertilization, and this type of fertilization is called external fertilization. What are the examples? In which type of animals does this fertilization occur? Fish, starfish. Now, so there are thousands of numbers of eggs which are laid by these aquatic animals. So why these so many eggs are laid down? These so many eggs are laid by the aquatic animals because some of these eggs gets destroyed or eaten up by other predators. So a small number of these eggs gets survived and somehow they develop into a new animal. Though these animals lay hundreds of eggs and release millions of sperm, all the eggs do not get fertilized and develop into new individuals. This is because the eggs and sperms get exposed to water movement, wind, rainfall. Also, there are other animals in the pond which may feed on eggs. Thus, protection of large number of eggs and sperms is necessary to ensure fertilization of at least a few of them. Let us look at the reproductive system of a female. So these are ovaries in which ovulation occurs, and this is uterus, this is oviduct, this is zygote, uterus wall, developing embryo. So this is a rough image. Zygote formation, development of embryo from the zygote, walls of cells enlarged, embedded of the embryo in the uterus enlarged. So please look into it and get a detailed knowledge of how the woman reproductive system works. Development of embryo, how the embryo develops, fertilization results. So how does an embryo develop? Fertilization results in the formation of zygote, which begins to develop into embryo. So embryo is the second stage after the zygote formation. The zygote divides immediately to give rise to a wall of cells. The cells then begin to form groups that develop into different tissues and organs of the body. This developing structure is termed as embryo. So what happens? The zygote divides repeatedly to give a wall of cells. A number of cells are produced after the division of zygote, and these cells developed. These are the cells which give shape to the organs of the body of the new individual. And this developing structure is termed as embryo. The embryo gets embedded in the wall of the uterus for further developments. We know that the development of the child occurs in uterus. The embryo continues to develop in the uterus. It gradually develops body parts such as hands, legs, head, eyes, ears, etc. The stage of embryo in which all the parts can be identified is called as fetus. What is fetus? When the embryo is visible and in the form of a child having definite body parts, it is called fetus. So internal fertilization takes place in health also. If I ask you, which type of fertilization does take place inside the hens? So this is internal fertilization, which takes place in hens. After fertilization, the zygote divides repeatedly and travels down the oviduct. As it travels down, many protective layers are. We are talking about the fertilization inside the hens. So when the zygote divides repeatedly, travels down the oviducts. As it travels down, many protective layers are formed around it. The hard cell that you see in hens' eggs is one such protective layer. In animals which undergo external fertilization, development of the embryo takes place outside the female body. We must know this thing. This is an important point, that in animals which undergo external fertilization, the development of the embryo takes place outside the female body. What are viviparous and oviparous animals? This is a very important thing. We must know what are viviparous and oviparous animals. So the animals which give birth to young ones like humans are called viviparous. Those animals which lay eggs are called oviparous. Now, the transformation of the larva into adult through drastic changes is called metamorphosis. We had studied sericulture in class 7th. Transformation of the larva into an adult through drastic changes is called metamorphosis. The larva gets transformed into an adult through drastic changes is called metamorphosis. Metamorphosis, what is a big change? If I ask you what is the meaning of metamorphosis, it is a big change. So we had studied in the sericulture class 7th science that when the larva gets converted into a big moth, it is called metamorphosis. So still now we had studied sexual reproduction in animals. Now we will study asexual reproduction in animals. What are the examples? In which type of animals, in which type of organisms does this reproduction occur? It is hydra and amoeba. In each hydra, there may be one or more bulges. So these bulges are the developing new individuals as they are called what? So this is hydra. A bulge occurs and the bulb gets separated from the original hydra. This type of reproduction in which only a single parent is involved is called asexual reproduction. Since new individuals develop from the buds in hydra, this type of asexual reproduction is called budding. So with this type of asexual reproduction is also called budding, in which the bud develops inside the hydra and gets separated after some time from the mother hydra. There is another process of asexual reproduction. There is another type. What is that? That is the fission. So till now we had studied the variety, the part of asexual production which is budding. Now we move towards studying the different category of asexual production, that is fission. In which type of organisms this type of asexual reproduction occurs? These are amoeba. This reproduction in which an animals reproduce by dividing into the new individuals is called binary fission. What happens? The nuclei of the amoeba divides, then the lining of the amoeba also gets divided and the two new individuals gets formed. There is a very important concept. What is cloning? Cloning is the production of an exact copy of a cell. Any other living part or a complete organism, cloning of an animal was successfully performed for the first time by Ian Wilmot and his colleagues at Roslin Institute of Edinburgh in Scotland. The first successful case of cloning was completed in Scotland by Ian Wilmot and his colleagues. What is cloning? Cloning is the production of an exact copy of a cell or any other living part or an organism from a mother. So cloning is the production of an exact copy of a cell, any other living part or a complete organism from a mother organism. So there are two types of sexual production we had studied. One is budding and second one is fission. So this is all for the day. Thank you for watching. Please like, share and subscribe. See you again next time.